This headless professor video is about the 2x2 contingency table and its use within statistics. We're going to begin by having two rows and two columns. We'll have the two rows represent the two conditions of our binary nominal variable, and we'll have the two columns be the two conditions of a second binary nominal variable. Each of the four cells has a name, A, B, C, or D. Cell A would have those subjects who have both variable 1 and variable 2. Cell B would have variable 1's condition, but not variable's 2. Cell C would have variable 2's condition, but not variable 1. And cell D would have neither. One of the basic rules of the 2x2 table is that every subject must be classified into a cell, and each subject can only go into one cell. The rows are usually reserved for an independent or predictor variable, such as the group of males versus the group of females. Pass or fail a test. The columns are for a dependent variable or a criterion variable, such as, does the subject vote yes or no? Do we pass or fail a given test? The marginal areas represent the totals. For example, cell A plus B would equal the total who answered variable 1 yes. C plus D would represent the total that answered variable 1 no. A plus C would represent the total who answered yes for variable 2. And B plus D would answer those who had variable 2 no. Our n should be A plus B plus C plus D. This depicts what we have in each cell and marginal. Let us suppose that we have an experimental group of 20 and a control group of 30 for a total sample size of 50. The dependent variable is whether or not the subjects pass or fail a test. Let's suppose that 15 out of 20 in the experimental group pass the test, but only 10 out of 30 in the control group passed the test. We can therefore see that 25 people total have passed and 25 have failed. What percent of the experimental group passed? Well, that would be according to the formula for percent, 100 times A divided by A plus C, or 75%. What percent of the control group passed? Well, that would be 100 times C divided by C plus D, for 33%. A repeated measures approach looks for consistency, stability, across different raters or time periods. Examples of qualitative measures would be interviewers or having quality judges. The kind of time period necessary could very easily be a before and after time period. That would give us a lot of data with which to calculate test retest reliability. So this is what the table would look like for long-term reliability analysis. We look at measure 1 and we look at measure 2 at a later point in time. If we measured on a binary nominal scale, it would look something like this. Cell A would have people who rated extremely highly both variables, and the other cells would have different combinations of this. Let's suppose that we had data that looked something like this. 10 people passed the test the first time. 15 people passed the test the second time. 8 people passed the test both times. What percent of the cases had it the first time, had the characteristic? 100 times A divided by A plus C should give us the answer, about 80%. How many cases had the characteristic the second time? 100 times A divided by A plus C. 53% in this case right here. That's the 2x2 contingency table from the Headless Professor.
Create your very own video podcast from PowerPoint. Log on to authorstream.com. It's absolutely free.